Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me show you how to set up a guest Wi-Fi network and why you should do that. So on airport base stations like Time Capsule and Airport Extreme and on many other Wi-Fi base stations, you have the ability to set up a guest network. This appears to be a separate base station from your main one. So you might see your Wi-Fi network and then also the second guest network. Now you should always set one of these up. Why? Because whenever you have guests come over the house and they want to access your Wi-Fi, maybe with their iPhone or Android phone or laptop or whatever, it's great to be able to freely give out the password to this guest network and not worry about them being on the same network as all of your other devices and computers and things in your house. And also, you won't be giving out a password that you may not want to change all that often. Instead, you're giving out this password to this guest network that is separate and you can easily change without having to reset the password on all of the different devices in your house. So to set up a guest network using an Apple Airport device like a Time Capsule or Airport Extreme or something, you would use Airport Utility on your Mac. Then you would select your airport device. From this information screen, you would hit Edit and then go into the Wireless section. You would then simply enable the guest network and give it a name. You want to set up security on it. You don't want to leave it with no security because that means everything's unencrypted. And you want to treat your guests a little better than that. So you set it up for WPA2 personal and you assign a password and verify the password. And of course, you can make the password something relatively easy to be able to tell them at least or write down. Try to include some letters and numbers in there to make it more secure. But you may not want to make it completely random like your regular network password would be that you'll be setting up on your computers because you'll be having guests entering these in all the time. But at least having a password, make sure that the data is encrypted going back and forth between your base station and their devices. And then of course keep in mind you may want to change this password from time to time depending upon how you're using your guest network. Then hit update and after a reboot your airport base station now would appear to have two networks, your main one and this special network with this name here. For all intents and purposes it seems like it's a completely separate device and devices don't see each other across these networks and people with one password won't be able to get into the other one. Now I would recommend setting this up now even if you don't have any plans in the immediate future to have guests use your Wi-Fi. Why? Because when the situation comes up, you don't want to have to go and fiddle around with setting things up. You want to have it already set up, already know the password, have it written it down, and then when somebody asks if they can access your Wi-Fi with their iPhone, you say, sure, here's the password. Now if you're not using an Apple base station, you may still be able to set one up. You're going to have to consult the documentation from your Wi-Fi router to see if it has this functionality and how to create the guest network. A lot of major brand third-party Wi-Fi routers will have this. However, if you're using Wi-Fi that comes with the box that you get from, say, your telephone company or your cable modem, then that might be a little more basic and may not have this functionality.